I'm a Ghanaian contemporary artist. And this course started at a very tender age when I started scribbling on the ground and then on walls. And my family did not discourage me from doing that, especially my parents, because they saw something in me. Though at that time, I did not know that this going to end as something, a profession, but they encouraged me to keep it up. I decided to be a full-time artist when I was taken through entrepreneurship by the late Brigitte Chemerton. After that course, I realized that it's not always about taking your certificates around and looking for another job. But whatever skill you have, you can improve on it and then do something to make money out of it. So I decided to be a full-time artist. That was right from 2009, after my national service. So as an artist and as a versatile artist, because I cannot do all that I have, all the knowledge that I acquired during my studies, because I cannot apply everything, I decided to concentrate on the painting. But you can see traces of all those other aspects of art in my works. You can, when you look at my paintings, you can see traces of sculpture. And people ask me, where do you get all these inspirations from? What I realize is that as an artist, you must be inspired, basically, by your environment. But my works are not limited to my environment alone, because I know as an artist, your works must write a history. Your works must document your culture as well as a way of life in your time. To tourism, we think tourism, what promotes tourism is about our beaches and our beautiful waterfalls. But as an artist, I believe that those tourists who come around, some of them, they are here as collectors. They collect some of our art pieces and they are inspired by those art pieces. They develop them and then use them for other things and then bring them back to us. And we have to also do the same. So wherever I find myself, I also pick inspirations from that environment. Whenever we are talking about items that we can export or things that we can export to generate income for the country, most of us talk about gold, cocoa, coffee, and so on. Living arts, which is a very important thing that we can export to generate income for the country. Because I know most of the people who visit the country, they come here because of our art. So if we pay much attention to that side, I think we can generate much income to help our national development. And many people ask me whether this is profitable. I think it is, and it depends on how you see it. And apart from its profitability, we can also preserve our culture for future generation through art. Because as I spoke about earlier on, I said art recalls history. It recalls daily life, day-to-day life activities. So we must remember that we cannot just leave our cultural elements behind. As we move, we must carry them along. So I incorporate these cultural elements, our symbols, our sculptural figures, into the works to preserve our culture for the future generation. On this note, I would like to thank the organizers of Sound Out event for this program, which supports arts and promotes culture. And to you watching, I would like to invite you to the next Sound Out event, which will be happening soon.